și Guru. Aleluia!
By the name, I'm called Eric Ochieng, AFCO Staff Europe, Kenya Campus, and I will wish to brief you on the lessons that I studied and that I handled with the students down here at AFCO Europe Kenya Campus. And one of the lessons that I handled, there were three main ones. One is last day events, dealing with the sequence of events, and this one was I started with many quite couple of chapters and spirit prophecy quotes dealing with the sequence of events. We had very many of them. First of all, we had Testimony for the Church, Volume 7, page 14, and saying those who are under the control of the Spirit of God and under the control of God Himself will catch up the steady tread of the sequence of events in the very last bit of Earth's history. And I will wish that you may study this deeply so that you may have something to even tell your fellows, those who are still in darkness, so that they may know Jesus. Another topic that we handled was concerning public evangelism, and this one was dealing majorly on the contacts and making bringing information to our people and even the people who are still outside the fold. And I will wish to say and even urge you that you may study this and try it as much as you can to go deep, and after reading the Bible and the Spirit of Prophecy, try to make contacts with people and then give them the information, let the conviction, the Spirit, the Holy Spirit give conviction, and also they may be converted. The last bit of my presentation was all about globalization issue. And the globalization, we defined it as unifying the whole world, coming into rebellion rebellion with the government of God Himself. And I will wish to tell you that the enemy is now striving and making all things rolling down in quick succession, that he may rebel against God, and they want just to have all people rebelling against the government of heaven. We studied this one deeply concerning the globalization or centralization, we may call it, starting from the book of Genesis chapter 11, where we had the first king presenting the enemy in the first phase of rebellion, after the enemy has rebelled against the government of heaven in the celestial courts above. He moved down to the kingdom, and the first president, the first king to present the enemy was Nimrod, a political leader who had strived to maintain and even to attain the political issue and even the political anarchy of the enemy. Now he brought all this. The first kingdom of him was Babel, and he tried to have many cities, and there are some seven things that should be laid down when the globalization should take place or should commence. One of them, there must be one language. Reading from the book of Genesis chapter 11 verse 1, we had one language by then, and they were trying to unify and bring people on board so that they may rebel against the government of heaven. And let me tell you, my brethren and sisters, the issue of language has been the main problem. And during the colonies, when they were fighting, we had many languages, and the ones which were at the peak were Germans, called Dutch, and we had the British. Now on competition to the level, the British overcame, and now we have one language, that is English. And another thing that must be laid down, it is building of the cities. When they were coming, that is Genesis chapter 11 verse 2, they came from the east, and there are some things which deals with the east. Eden itself was built on the east. We have the wise men coming from the east. If you read the book of Matthew 2 verse 11, we had the sealing angel coming from the east, and we have very many things, and even Jesus Christ is going to come from the east, and we have also sons rising from the east. There are very good things that are coming from the East, and I would wish even to tell you that in this context, the rebellers of God themselves, they strive and collect themselves, they guard themselves so that they may come from the East, where good things are coming, and it means they are rebelling against God. Another thing that they should be laying down to bring one world government, it is cities. That we need just to know that the enemy is now building cities all over. And the first president by then was Nimrod. He built very many cities in Canaan. He built many of them, reading from the book of Genesis chapter 10 verse 8 and Genesis chapter 11 verse 9 and 10. They had very many cities. The third point that they should be laying down for globalization to take place, it is what we call education. That's why when Daniel and his fellows got into the Babylon, the realm of Babylon, the first thing they were to learn the Chaldean's language. And that is one of the things that must be laid down so that everything should be one. And I tell you, brethren, let us study this so that we may have everything. Another thing which must be laid down, it is the foodstuff. The enemy is now striving so that he may confuse our minds to make right decision. Concerning the food, it is true that our first parents, Adam and Eve, fell in this manner and in this point. The same when Christ came into the wilderness, the first temptation was concerning food. Majorly, it has been a problem since, and it is the main thing which brought our fall from our first parents. Another thing that you should note on concerning this one, what made Daniel and Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego to decide for their God? The very first point that was brought before them was concerning food. They must eat the food that comes from the king's table. Has been a problem, and the enemy is now fighting to bring all this processed food that they may confuse our minds. That's why if you read the book of Daniel chapter 1 verse 8, Daniel purposed in his heart that he may not damage himself or defile himself with the king's meat, that the mind might be confused to make right decisions and comprehend the spiritual things. Another thing that must be laid down for globalization to take place, it is the cord, the dress. Everything has been a problem, and the enemy is now bringing all this. First, and the foremost, it is true that our first parent fell after their fall because they had one robe coming from God himself, because God created them in his own image and had them a very good cloth, a very good garment, clothed them with majesty and power and great light. And now the enemy tried to bring another thing. Reading from the book of Genesis chapter 1, chapter 3, verse 1, the Bible says that the enemy was cunning and subtle, and he deceived the human race. Now he brought another garment altogether, that they had the fig tree. Now we had two designers in the book of Genesis. The first designer is God himself. Another designer, it is the enemy. And it has been fighting over and over about the dress code. May God bless you. And as you will be studying the next point and the very note, take points. And may God bless you so much. Thank you so much.
AFCO Europe Kenya Campus.
Christ
Method
in
Action.